Owen was an exceptional person. His character, sense of humor, and morals were unmatched.
I was on the road in Dallas with Hockey Night in Canada. Talk about Owen, the whole meeting.
There was an ugly fight against the company that he worked for.
No, I was in your tongue, lady.
Had this David and Goliath battle where you had this multi-billion dollar company trying to squash the widow.
I never felt that I got the justice that I was seeking.
Some powerful images and words there, part of a documentary about the life of Calgary wrestler Owen Hart. It opened at the Monaco International Film Festival and won four major awards, including a Best Documentary Short Editing honor. Film editor Wes Beiko joins us now. Thanks for being with us this morning.
Thank you for having me.
You have a really interesting story about how you ended up working on this film. So tell us a little bit about, I guess, the wonder of Kijiji.
Well, it all started from an ad I decided to post on Kijiji back in February. I got a few replies for weddings, some small editing jobs, but nothing really big. And then finally in June, right after I graduated, I was contacted by a man named James A. Sinclair. He is the founder of B Institute Inc., the company I currently work for. They have a media production department, and they were going to do a promo video for Martha Hart. It originally started as a 5-minute video and turned into a 20-minute short film.
Wow. And so what was it like working on this documentary? We talked a little bit about the fact that you didn't really know that this was about Owen Hart. I'm sure you know a lot now. And I guess what was that like for you?
At the start, it was just really surreal because you've always heard of, especially if you've grown up in Calgary and around the area, that the whole Hart family. Exactly. So for me, it was just really surreal meeting Martha, seeing all the behind the scenes stuff and seeing them actually as people rather than what you kind of hear through the media.
Talk a little bit about maybe film editing and what goes into that for maybe the person at home that doesn't know so much.
What goes into it is a lot of work, for sure. It's a lot of trial and error. You really start with a bunch of clips that we have that we filmed on set, and then from there you break it down into smaller clips, and then from those smaller clips you start piecing it together into one big film.
Like what we're seeing right now?
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about the documentary. People that see this, what are they going to learn? What are they going to know?
They're going to learn first about the life and death of Owen Hart, and then finally it kind of evolves into the foundation of the Owen Hart Foundation through Martha Hart and where Martha is currently today.
Did you think when you responded to a Kijiji ad or posted a Kijiji ad that you would end up an international award winner?
Definitely not.
Surreal.
Surreal.
And tell me a little bit, did you get to go to Monaco?
Unfortunately not.
No? Oh, that's too bad. So what's next for you? Now, you just graduated from high school, so are you going to continue down this path?
Yeah, I'd like to continue down this path. Probably not so much towards schooling, but I am planning on working on more films. I'm currently working on a screenplay.
And finally, why should not just Calgarians, everyone see this documentary?
Really, the documentary itself shows how you can take tragedy and turn it into something good and amazing. And I think really every one of us has that in our life, something tragic. And that really shows that even at the most, the rock bottom point in your life, you can turn it into something amazing.
Wonderful. Thanks for being again here with us again, Wes.
Thank you for having me.
We're leaving you now with another look at the documentary. Here you go.
He was so kind to every single person that he ever met.
We're here cheering for you guys.
Great things about the Owen Hart Foundation, about Martha and her work, is that they continue to do the work every day, and it matters.
Dad still lives in me. He still lives in Athena. He still lives in Mom. But he also lives in this foundation.
Hopefully sometime in the future I can run the foundation with my brother. Help my mom bring in some more outstanding guests.
It's just the beginning.